Two Krabby Patties and Silent Guys. Dan squirmed as he closed the door on the kitchen's window. Just as fast as he gave the order, SpongeBob was at the door with two Krabby Patties and Silent Guys. Order up, he shouted with his signature enthusiasm, and we were all happy. He walked towards the customer's table and gave them their order. Krabby Patties and Silent Guys for the gentleman, and increased them. He smiled and laughed with a laugh between us, but we didn't want to pull the trigger. The customers just ignored the happy sponge and proceeded to eat their food. SpongeBob walked back to the kitchen and sat down as he waited for another order. Business had been slow recently, he could tell by the lack of work and by how much was continued. He's been working on a Krusty Krab for so long, he actually lost track of how many years he's worked. He loves his job, making patties is his love. He's gotten to meet so many people, not only does he make the patties, he gets to serve if he wins, which in his opinion is every bit as enjoyable as making a burger. But to SpongeBob, the best thing is when he sees the happy face of his boss. SpongeBob has been a major crush on the leader of the station since he first started working in the Krusty Krab. He never has gotten to tell the old crab himself, since he thinks he will be rejected anyway. There's nothing left more than money, so he keeps his affection to himself. Suddenly the kitchen door opened and Rednecks stepped inside. We're closing early today. Slow business costs a fortune, Leonard said bitterly. Crab stared at SpongeBob and now adding to find an expression plastered across his face. Suddenly something twinkled and SpongeBob snapped. He raised towards Eugene and got on his knees. I know business has been slow, and there is nothing I can do about that. So how about you let me treat you right? Raised in a mellow stare at the mellow sound. Are you offering yourself to me? I haven't done this since I was a sailor. What is this mean? Wait, I want you. That was enough to get the old crab going. Eugene took up his coat. A SpongeBob placed his spongy, yellow, and his red, hard coat. He took them in for him. He sat to wait like his life depended on it. The old crab was speechless. This man really, the old guy was a crab. He was a fucking man. He was getting shit done. So before he broke up the field, he put it away and ran home to the sky. He was now on his stomach for the rest of the year, stripping himself as Eugene and all of the rest of his body. Then he stared at the cube, and the last that was in front of him, waiting to be filled with his sex. I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready. SpongeBob said, regressively louder. He snapped out of his appreciation for the last and slammed into the sky. Not concerned, he sat for hurting him. SpongeBob yelled as Eugene picked up the pace.
Black sheep, have you any
clues?
Yes sir, yes sir, be nice.
He kept slamming into the
top of the
last
stone.
And suddenly Spidler became
pain for the king. One for the boy who lives down the lane.
To A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.A.
Baby bags go.
His erection suddenly became visible as he raised her with Spanish bodies and his cock in his mouth.
Oh, well, she have you any wool? Yes sir, baby, he was full. One's in an endy jumper, one's in an endy frock, one's for the little girl with holes in her sock. Baba, white sheep, have you any wool? Yes sir, baby, he was full.
Yes sir,
baby, that's full.